Welcome back to Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. So today, I'm going to be doing Nutty Acres Act 2. So, let's enter the world. Looks like we got 3 Jiggies and 3 Jinjo tokens to collect. Okay, here we are. It's pretty much the same as Act 1. Sometimes there's little, like, environmental changes between the acts, like maybe it's during a different part of the day or something. I don't know. Well, first thing is first. Let's change your vehicle up, because that one's too slow for my taste. And this car's is kind of difficult to handle, not gonna lie. Although I did get, I got those spoilers, didn't I? So, maybe if I add those. I think it's under gadgets. Hopefully these actually, like, change how it works, and it's not just a cosmetic item. Alright, let's see. Yeah, that's definitely easier to control. Alright, there's a Jiggy in the middle here. Gotta get the music notes. Let's talk to Mumbo. Let's see here. Tick-tock bang. So we gotta use this tractor to transport the ticking bomb to Bottles, who is over by, who's on the airstrip by the volcano. Alright, right away, put this in the back. And let's take this shortcut here. You know, you gotta save those, like the half a second you save there, you know? And of course they put enemies in the way. What a bunch of assholes. Alright, looks like they didn't knock the bomb out, which is good. I swear they did that like so many times before when I was trying to do this. And if they do that, it's like, it's game over. You can't like jump out, put the bomb back in, and then get going again. You can't make the trophy time when that happens. It's a good thing we took that to an expert. Alright, that's done. Where's my car? Alright. That was amazing. I should have got some sort of achievement for that. Alright, and now inside the volcano here, we got Humba Wumba. She's got a challenge for us, but, well, this doesn't seem right. Oh, there's token, or there's music notes. How do I get up there? You know, oh, you know what? I can knock them down. Good thing they don't get destroyed by this lava here. I just want the gold one. Just give me the gold one. Of course, it's targeting everyone but the gold one. There we go. I'm about to die. What are you, like, die in the lava? What is that? Alright, so we got these fireballs everywhere, or, you know, three fireballs that you gotta transport to water. So the trolley seems like it would be a good job for this, but it's a player's choice. And I think the trolley's a little too slow for my taste, so I'm just gonna fix this up really quick, you know, maybe add an engine. Maybe he had two engines. Add another gas tank to compensate. Alright, you know what? Wait. Okay, the X button. There we go. I'm gonna move this towards the back. Hopefully that works. Right, and this kind of vehicle seems like it might be useful for future challenges, so I'm going to save it as a new blueprint. And I'm going to call it, how do you use this little keyboard here? Let's just call it souped. Whoops. Souped up. Trolley. Okay. And you know what? Symbols. Where's like a dash? Do you see a dash? Like that. Does that look right? I don't know. Or is it just one word, souped up? I don't know. Alright, I'm done. Start game. Let's do this. Oh yeah, that's noticeably faster than the old trolley. Too bad you can't take this in the showdown town. Let's get this in the trolley. Get this to some water. Okay, well that works, whatever. I was gonna jump out and actually put it in the water, but, you know, it's faster to just drive in the water. Let's get that one in. Hopefully it just rolls down, there we go. And now the last one. its way over here, I guess. This is going well. Whoops. Maybe I shouldn't have souped this up. Alright, I got it. I just gotta get to the water before the time runs out. And I'm done. Alright, I gotta wait for it to sink first. There we go. The little, like, victory sound effect was all muffled because I'm underwater. Alright, that's done. Okay, and now... got this guy over here. Trophy. Is this the actual, like, trophy guy? Trophy Thomas? Alright, so we got just an old-fashioned race. I'm gonna choose custom vehicle. My little car. Alright, and go! Drive through the checkpoints. And I noticed that, in that little, like, demonstration, Trophy Thomas was driving significantly faster than he actually does during the race. And he left little, like, tire marks that are still in the game. That's weird. Alright, and I won by a fucking mile. Best out of three? What is this scam? I don't know what happens if you actually lose this time. Like, if it is it actually best out of three, or did he just say that? Like, if you lose now, do you actually lose the challenge, or what? I don't know, I'm not gonna find out, because I'm not gonna lose. Well, I just tried to save some time by just trying to jump the water instead of going over the bridge, but I think it ended up costing me. What the hell was that? Okay, there's the finish line, and I win again. Alright, that's all the jiggies in this level. And now... there's just the matter of the Jinjo tokens. Right, there should be one around here. Here he is. Thank you. Okay, and this is a Jinjo sumo wrestling kind of thing. Okay, let's just start a new game. And you have to push him out of the force field without getting pushed out yourself. And this isn't going well. Whoa, I almost lost. Okay. The problem with this car is that it's not very heavy. But that's kind of the whole point. It's not supposed to be heavy because it's supposed to be fast. So, like, I don't have the weight to be able to just push it. Come on. Oh, wait, I might have this. Yes, I got it. Alright, I got that one. Where did my car go? Can you collect notes when you're still in your car, or do you actually have to get out? Oh no, you can still get them. That's good to know. Alright, and now over here in the swamp region, there should be another Jinjo. Whoa, hey. You have, like, no grip in this, like, swamp water. It's really annoying. This is a Jinjo taxi challenge. All right, Jinjo taxi. Oh, you gotta take the Jinjo from point A to point B. And for this one, they provide me with a vehicle already, so, guess I gotta take it. Well, this isn't going well at all. What the hell are you freaking out about back there? Seriously. Oh, he fell out. Get back in. And that's done. His dialogue doesn't really make sense because he's still in the original spot. He's like, this is better than my old place, but he's still in the old place. Is it supposed to be like that? Or did my game glitch? Alright. And now, it's another Jinjo somewhere. I think it's over here, like where I took the other one. Where I just took that one for the Jinjo challenge, I think. That was over here, right? I don't know. Oh, right here by where the, this is right where the door was in Act 1, I think. This is a Jinjo race challenge. Alright, Jinjo race. This, just, you know, an old-fashioned race. Just like that one Jiggy I just got. Go through the checkpoints. Well, this... Okay. Am I still winning? No, I'm losing. Oh, come on, that's not fair. My car's too fast for this stuff. And I win. Alright, that's it. I think I'm done with this act. Let's just return to Show Downtown. And I got 4 trophies, so I can go over and get a Jiggy by going to Trophy Tom up there, but I currently can't get up there because I don't have the correct parts. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get these 3 and just drive over the bank, and there they go. And I just unlocked a new world. So I can take the little globe over to its pedestal if I wanted to. But I also unlocked Nutty Acres Act 3 over here, which has a little picture of Gruntilda. Because it's a Gruntilda challenge, and for beating those, you unlock certain vehicles. Or you unlock special parts for your vehicle. So, yeah, I think that's what I'm going to be doing in the next video. So, thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next part.